it has been filled with your glory. And thank you for everything in our life. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen. Amen.
Good morning, church. Yesterday, we had a program designed by the Thomas for working for Jesus. Deacon Thomas, can you please come forward? Unfortunately, we had a very good day, but at the same time, it was not possible for us to walk through the rain. So Deacon Thomas, being the commander general for us, is going to lead the march for Jesus Christ. Yes, Brother Mavis, can you please come on the keyboard to lead us in when the saints go marching in. Mm-hmm. And Brother Alpha, is he around?
Yeah.
Brother Alpha, can you please come on drum? We want to dance this morning for Jesus Christ. So can you please all stand up? We are going to march for Jesus Christ this morning.
Amen.
And the song goes like this. The song goes like this. And when I say, go marching in. And when I say, go marching. Okay. So let everybody stand up now. And let us walk for Jesus. Are we ready? Go marching in. Oh, when I say, go marching in. I want to be the number. Oh, when I say, go marching in. Oh, when I saw the need to shine. Oh, when I saw the need to shine. I want to be as the prologue we have from our Reverend this morning, it goes with the theme we have, which is dealing with negative attitude in the way of Jesus. Dealing with negative attitude in the way of Jesus. Our Bible reading, the theme, it's 1 Corinthians chapter 13, verses 4 to 7. 1 Corinthians chapter 13, verses 4 to 7. It says, love is very patient and kind, never jealous or envious.
Mm-hmm.
Love never boastful or proud. Love never haughty or selfish or rude. Love does not demand its own way. It is not irritable or touchy. It does not hold grudges and hardly even notice when others do it wrong.
Mm-hmm.
It is never glad about injustice, but rejoices whenever truth wins out. If you love someone, you will always believe in him, always expect the best of him, and always stand your ground in defending him. Hallelujah. Yeah, in the past few weeks, we have been talking at the Bible study class about attitude, as taught us by our beloved teacher Deacon Thomas. There are two types of attitudes, positive attitude and negative attitude. I am sure we don't really have any problems with people with positive attitude, since we always prefer anyway to be surrounded by people with positive attitude. So we are not going to use this limited time talking about positive attitude. In as long as we cannot avoid or run away also with people with negative attitude, either in our places of work or in our church, surprisingly, or even at home or in public places, how do we deal with this negative sensitivity? In the way of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Negative attitude or negative sensitivity is the mother of anger, rudeness, and insults and bad feelings. This morning, we will try and examine how the followers of Jesus should respond to negative attitudes such as rudeness, direct or indirect insults, based on what we know of how Jesus responded to rudeness and insults in the Bible. I want us to learn from Jesus' life in the Gospels how to survive and thrive when we are treated rudely, confronted by people with negative attitude, either at work or among our Christian community. Every day or every week, you are likely to be insulted, you are likely to be criticized or mistreated by someone with sometimes no justification at all. How do you deal with those situations? Do you fly off the handle? Do you dish it out right back? Or how is that working out for you? If we are going to respond to negative attitude, rudeness, or insults in the way of Jesus, we first have to get control of that dangerous emotional beast called anger or over-bloated ego or complex. And this brings us back again to what we once told, that God created everything in pairs, man and woman, hot and cold, summer and winter, and so is anger. We have positive anger, and we also have negative anger. In other words, we also have good anger, which reminds us of a bumper sticker I saw the other day, which reads, "If you are not outraged, you aren't paying attention." And what does that mean? In other words, even when you are admonished during a message and your conscience is not touched, then your mind is not somewhere, your mind is somewhere else, but not in the church, either in your cell phone or sleeping off during the service. There is certainly enough injustice, needless pain and destruction, ugliness and rudeness in the world today to cause every one of us to be angry. And such anger might lead us to take action to improve an injustice or unfair situation. Such anger may move you to compassion. Anger in itself is not morally bad. Anger is merely an emotional and psychological response to something that does not seem just or fair. It simply means you are sensitive in response to a situation which calls for attention. You have to be really angry before you can effectively correct any ungodly acts or save an ugly situation from corrupting our moral values. There are two sides to attitudes, positive attitude and negative attitude. Positive attitude is when you are allowing your positive anger to correct an ungodly act or saving a situation from getting or becoming ugly to the detriment of others. Negative attitude, on the other hand, is when you allow your negative anger within you to bring out the negative side of your virtue, to make you do things which you may later regret. Nobody wants to associate with a person who has negative attitude. They are miserable people who are always angry, complaining, as anger is also infectious and only goes to poison you and lower your immune system. J. Charles advised us about how we can unchain the baggage of negativity we unknowingly or unconsciously are carrying about with us in our lives. Someone once told me that if you want to be smart, if you want to be happy, surround yourself with smart people. Surround yourself with happy people.
Yes.
The same can be true for many things. If you want to be a person with